الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين ألف لام ميم تلك آيات الكتاب الحكيم هدى ورحمة للمحسنين الذين يقيمون الصلاة ويؤتون الزكاة وهم بالآخرة هم يوقنون أولئك على هدى من ربهم وأولئك هم المفلحون ومن الناس من يشتري لهو الحديث ليضل عن سبيل الله بغير علم ويتخذها هزوا أولئك لهم عذاب مهين وإذا تتلى عليه آياتنا ولى مستكبرا كأن لم يسمعها كأن في أذنيه وقرا فبشره بعذاب أليم إن الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات لهم جنات النعيم خالدين فيها وعد الله حقا وهو العزيز الحكيم خلق السماوات بغير عمد ترونها وألقى في الأرض رواسي أن تميد بكم وبث فيها من كل دابة وأنزلنا من السماء ماء فأنبتنا فيها من كل زوج كريم هذا خلق الله فأروني ماذا خلق الذين من دونه بل الظالمون في ضلال مبين ولقد آتينا لقمان الحكمة أن اشكر لله ومن يشكر فإنما يشكر لنفسه ومن كفر فإن الله غني حميد وإذ قال لقمان لابنه وهو يعظه يا بني لا تشرك بالله إن الشرك لظلم عظيم ووصينا الإنسان بوالديه حملته أمه وهنا على وهن وفصاله في عامين أن اشكر لي ولوالديك إلي المصير وإن جاهداك على أن تشرك بي ما ليس لك به علم فلا تطعهما وصاحبهما في الدنيا معروفا واتبع سبيل من أناب إلي ثم إلي مرجعكم فأنبئكم بما كنتم تعملون يا بني إنها إن تك مثقال حبة من خردل فتكن في صخرة أو في السماوات أو في الأرض يأتي بها الله إن الله لطيف خبير يا بني أقم الصلاة وأمر بالمعروف وانه عن المنكر واصبر على ما أصابك إن ذلك من عزم الأمور ولا تصعر خدك للناس ولا تمشي في الأرض مرحا إن الله لا يحب كل مختال فخور وقصد في مشيك واغضض من صوتك إن أنكر الأصوات لصوت الحمير
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته ما شاء الله حياكم الله my dear beautiful brothers and last night صلاة التراويح and صلاة العشاء and مغرب I wasn't here and I visited the city or the town Bolton, is it a city or a town? It's a town. It's not a city yet. It's largest town, mashallah. Mashallah, that's mashallah, important piece of information, mashallah. Alhamdulillah. That's a geography lesson for you, inshallah. Barakallahu fiqh. Jazakullah khairan. And so, alhamdulillah, that's where I was. I went to, mashallah, Masjid al-Tawfiq, the masjid where Sheikh Mohamed Mustafa al-Shaybani where the Sheikh leads the Salah and teaches, and Alhamdulillah, that's his community, mashallah. And so Alhamdulillah, I just got back in a couple of hours before Fajr, Alhamdulillah. And Alhamdulillah, here we are. We don't want to miss Fajr reflection, you know? So inshallah ta'ala, we will continue inshallah ta'ala with our journey. This morning, we are beginning a new journey. The journey that we are beginning is the journey of Surat Luqman. And inshallah ta'ala, this journey, hopefully, and it's going to be a very beneficial journey as always, but this journey is not going to be too long. The surahs right now, they're getting shorter and shorter. The journeys are getting shorter in the surahs that we will be going through until we get to Suratul Ahzab. Suratul Ahzab is going to be a bit long, inshallah ta'ala, as we will see soon, bi'inillahi ta'ala. And Yasir is not here, but inshallah ta'ala, he asked me a question, young Yasir, and I said to him, inshallah ta'ala, that question will be answered when we get to Surat Al-Ahzab. So I'm sure he's eagerly waiting by the time we get to Surat Al-Ahzab, inshallah ta'ala. But if we begin, mashallah, this surah today, this morning, inshallah ta'ala, Surat Al-Luqman, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala began with the letters Alif Lam Mim. And those are the broken letters, as we know, and al-huruf al-muqatta'ah. We don't know what they mean. Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows what they mean. Although Imam al-Razi, rahimahullah ta'ala, has mentioned an explanation, and he said at the beginning of the Qur'an, especially Surah Al-Fatiha, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught us that we need to seek His help to actually find the right path. Ihdina as-sirat al-mustaqim. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us to the straight path. In that ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He taught us like we need to seek Allah's help to follow the straight path. And then the next surah, which is Surah Al-Baqarah, Allah begins with what? Alif Lam Mim. It is as if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us, guys, before I teach you what the straight path is, I just want you to know your knowledge is very limited. And one of the ways I can show you that your knowledge is very limited is Alif Lam Mim. Do you know what it means? We don't know what Alif Lam Mim means. That's like an explanation that Imam al-Razi rahimahullah ta'ala has given to these letters. Alif Lam Mim. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala after that has said, Tilka ayat تلك آيات الكتاب الحكيم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, تلك آيات الكتاب الحكيم. These are the verses of the wise scripture. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, هُدًا وَرَحْمَةً لِلْمُحْسِنِينَ. This particular kitab, this particular book, is guidance and mercy for those people who are muhsinun, for those who do good. It is as if someone has asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Allah, can you give us the characteristics of those people who are the muhsinun? Who are these people? And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to tell us who these people are. الَّذِينَ يُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةِ وَيُؤْتُونَ الزَّكَاةِ وَهُمْ بِالْآخِرَةِ هُمْ يُوقِنُونَ. They are the ones who establish the prayer. And they are the ones who give the zakah. And وَهُمْ بِالْآخِرَةِ هُمْ يُوقِنُونَ. When it comes to akhirah, they have absolutely proper certainty. They are certain about the akhirah, the next life. They don't just believe, they are certain about it. That absolutely the day of akhirah is going to come. وَهُمْ بِالْآخِرَةِ هُمْ يُوقِنُونَ. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أُولَٰئِكَ عَلَىٰ هُدًى مِنْ رَبِّهِمْ وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ. As you can see, the beginning of the surah is quite similar to the beginning of Surah Al-Baqarah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أُولَٰئِكَ عَلَىٰ هُدًى مِنْ رَبِّهِمْ وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ. These are rightly guided by their Lord, and it is they who will prosper. They will be the muflihun, the successful ones. And now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to tell us another group of people. Those who are against the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَشْتَرِي لَهْوَ الْحَدِيثِ لِيُضِلَّ عَنْ سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ بِغَيْرِ عِلْمٍ وَيَتَّخِذَهَا هُزُوَى أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمْ عَذَابٌ مُهِيمٌ. But there is the sort of person who pays for distracting tales, intending without any knowledge to lead other people from Allah's way and to hold it up to ridicule. There will be humiliating torment for him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about here a group of people or certain individuals. It was mentioned that this ayah was revealed regarding a man who was called An-Nadr ibn al-Harith. An-Nadr ibn al-Harith, he was from Quraysh. He lived in Mecca during the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So what he did was, and when he saw the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the da'wah he was giving and the stories that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was telling the people and the Quran that was being revealed to him, he said, I am going to challenge this. And what did he do? He went to Persia. And then he has learned the stories, the Persian stories, the tales and things like that. So he came back to the city of Mecca. And he used to say to the people, look at the stories that I have with me. I can tell you similar stories or stories that are better than the stories of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَشْتَرِي لَهْوَ الْحَدِيثِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but there is the sort of person who pays for distracting tales. So he went, bought these stories and came back to the city of Mecca, and then he used to propagate these stories. What did he used to do? Whenever he sees the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam speaking to a group of people, when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam leaves, he used to go to those people and he used to say to them, I have something better than what Muhammad has. That's what he used to say. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَشْتَرِي لَهْوَ الْحَدِيثِ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ. Also, in this ayah, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ, the great companion, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, look what he said. He used to swear by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he used to say, what this ayah is teaching us is that music is haram. The ulama, when they have said that music is haram, they have used this ayah as an evidence. وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَشْتَرِي لَهْوَ الْحَدِيثِ لِيُضِلَّ عَنْ سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. Another Ibn al-Harith, one of the things that he used to do also was, he bought a couple of ladies, like female slaves who used to sing. And he used to say to the people, come and listen to my ladies singing. So Abdullah ibn Mas'ud said that this ayah means, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us that music is absolutely haram. And there is a hadith where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam has said, at the end of time, some of my people, some of my followers, some of the people of my ummah, they will make certain things halal, which are originally haram. Among the things that the people will make halal is music. And this is some of the things that the Prophet ﷺ has mentioned that will happen at the end of times. And this is exactly what we are seeing right now. some people are saying music's halal when it was haram. So music has to be, we have to avoid music. We have to stay away from music. Many people who made tawbah from music, they will tell you, once they have made tawbah from music, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given them, their iman has become stronger. They felt a lot better. They were able to memorize the Qur'an and learn the Qur'an after they have left the music, subhanAllah. Music and Qur'an can never occupy the same heart. If you are listening to music regularly and you are addicted to it, you can never learn Qur'an. It's very difficult. And also, when someone listens to music, that person will easily become munafiq. It's quite serious. So music nowadays, as we know, so many people are addicted to music. But the majority of people, when you see them, especially young people these days, when you see them, men, women, you will see them always listening to music. They want to distract themselves from reality. Why are people listening to music? You need to ask yourself, what's the point of listening to music? Okay. Music is mizmar min mazamir al-shaytan. It's the Quran of the shaytan music. And it encourages a lot of evil things. Subhanallah. So music is quite serious. So if you want to, mashallah, if you want to make tawbah from music, you should do it as soon as possible. Okay? Because just imagine if you were to die listening to music. Some people, they go to bed when they're listening to music. While they're listening to music, they can't go to sleep without listening to music. Just imagine that person passing away. Okay, at night, while they just had their headphones and listening to music as they were sleeping. Subhanallah. Just imagine. Okay, so remember, وَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَشْتَرِي لَهْوَ الْحَدِيثِ لِيُضِلَّ عَنْ سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. So what it does, it's like listening to music, it will take you away from the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Music will never encourage you to be obedient to Allah. So it's very, very important. We have to pay attention to this. Okay, we know so many people are really addicted to music. That's a reality. And if you listen to it over and over, what will happen? You will definitely become addicted to it. So remember, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمْ عَذَابٌ مُهِيمٌ. Those people, they will be a humiliating torment. For such, they will be a humiliating torment for him or for them or for her. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَإِذَا تُتْلَى عَلَيْهِ آيَاتُنَا وَلَّا مُسْتَكْبِرًا. When our verses are recited to him, he turns away disdainfully, as if he had not heard them, as if there were heaviness in his ears. Tell him that there will be a painful torment. And now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will remind us of those people who have iman. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ لَهُمْ جَنَّاتُ النَّعِيمِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, but for those who believe and do righteous deeds, there will be gardens of bliss. خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, where they will stay, that is Allah's true promise. And He is the Almighty, All-Wise. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about His creation. خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ بِغَيْرِ عَمَدٍ تَرَوْنَهَا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, He created the heavens without any visible support, pillars. And He placed firm mountains on the earth in case it should shake under you. And He spread all kinds of animals around it. We sent down water from the sky, with which we made every kind of good plant grow on earth. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, هذا خلق الله. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, all this is Allah's creation. Now, show me what your other gods have created. This is a challenge. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, I have created all of this. Can you show me what your gods have created? هذا خلق الله فأروني ماذا خلق الذين من دونه. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala concluded the ayah, بل الظالمون في ضلال مبين. No, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, the disbelievers are clearly astray. They went astray. The story of Luqman begins. I think we should not begin this story. We need to begin this story, inshallah ta'ala, on Saturday. Inshallah ta'ala, because the story deserves a lot of attention, and it deserves, mashallah, we need to go a little bit in depth, because the advice that Luqman is going to give his son is going to be a very powerful advice. So inshallah ta'ala, there will be so many lessons that we can learn from that. So inshallah ta'ala, I'm not going to begin this morning, but inshallah ta'ala, we will be beginning this story bi'inillah on Saturday bi'inillah ta'ala. Tonight, like Brother Hassan has mashallah mentioned, and tonight will be the beginning of the last 10 days. Inshallah ta'ala, that means tonight will be the 21st of Ramadan. It could be Laylatul Qadr. Remember, we will do the Taraweeh as usual. Also, we will have Salatul Layl, Tahajjud, as we have always been doing from the beginning. But the last 10 days, Tahajjud will begin tonight, inshallah ta'ala. So the time the Tahajjud will be beginning is 2:30 bi'idhnillah ta'ala. So please, inshallah ta'ala, pay attention to this. You don't want to miss, inshallah ta'ala, the last 10 days and make the most of it. And like Brother Hassan has mentioned, inshallah ta'ala, make sure that if you want to come to the i'tikaf, that you go through, inshallah ta'ala, the process, and hopefully everything will be sorted out for you. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept all of our good deeds. And I ask, inshallah ta'ala, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make those brothers who want to do the i'tikaf to make it easy for them, inshallah ta'ala. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make them get the best out of this, inshallah ta'ala, Ramadan and this i'tikaf. And those of you who will be together, inshallah ta'ala, doing the i'tikaf, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala strengthen your brotherhood, inshallah ta'ala, and the love that you have for one another. So inshallah ta'ala, we wish them all the best, those of you who will be doing the i'tikaf, and inshallah ta'ala, we'll go through the rulings of i'tikaf as the days, as we progress, inshallah ta'ala, as the days begin, the days of the last 10 days, bi'inillahi ta'ala. So jazakumullahu khairan, and wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.